All right, so we're going to have Fred Crislip to break. Fred is a skill level 7, 9 player. 7 and 8 ball, skill level 9 and 9. Fred to break. So Fred elects to break the side of the 8 ball rack. Pocket a low ball on the break. A little surprised to see Fred miss that shot there. This is, like I said, a lot of folks here, just not morning players. You hear a lot of players complain about shooting in the morning. So Mark to the table. So Mark looking at that 9 ball. Problem is the 11-15. So pretty open table here for Fred. Trick might be at the 5 ball. It's a little bit of a spot where there's a couple balls around it. Might make it a little difficult. Fred pockets the four on the side. Shot there by Fred, drawing that cue over there, bumped the 10 out of the way. All right, so Fred takes the early lead, 1-0 over Mark Gokey.
Thank you.
Sorry about that, folks. Just doing a little bit of housekeeping. Sometimes the software doesn't play like it's supposed to. Found out that over there on the YouTube channel, it still said we were stream testing. So we resolved that. So Fred looking at that seven ball and how he's going to get on the eight. Ooh, did he hit it? Did he get it? Looks pretty good. Nice shot to get on that eight ball and pocket it. Good shot by Fred. So Fred takes a 3-0 lead over Mark Gokey. Mark Gokey to the table on the high balls. So I think if you mark, you might want to take that nine ball now. That's it. So Mark is going to call that eight ball in that top side pocket. Mark gets on the board, 1-3. I'd like to say thank you to the APA, both Greater Washington, D.C., APA. That's pretty much my home these days. Spend my time out at Bank Shots, Bar and Grill. And I'd like to say thank you to the National APA as well for having me out, covering their event today. It's an honor. Mark Gokey to break, down 1-3. So the last game of eight ball. Thank you. So Fred looks like he's going to spin this 11 ball in the corner pocket. Maybe set up for the 10 following. Oh, he hit that with much more pace than I was expecting. I thought he was going to hit that ball very easy. He had other thoughts in his mind. So the 10 ball is the clear problem here. So Fred bumps that 6-10, creates a little separation for the 10 ball from the 6. So he may elect to bank this. I'll say maybe he might want to bank it back where he's at now, in that corner pocket, because if he hangs it, it might block the pocket there. And it'll make the cue ball traverse up table towards the 8. Or he might just try to cut it in the corner. That's what he did, cut it in the corner. It's going to have a beautiful angle for the 8. Nicely done. All right, so Fred cleans that up, leads 4-1. They'll be moving the 9 ball now. My name is Wayne Everhart from ThinkTechMD. We're out here today at the Revolutions Darts and Billiards in Fairfax, Virginia. We're covering the US Amateur Preliminaries. Thank you all for joining us. Please go ahead and share our stream, like our page. And Fred Crislip, the break, leading 4-1 over Mark Gokey. Well, he made the wing ball plus. You can see the one to go in that bottom right-hand corner pocket. So I'd like to say thank you again to Scott Wilburn and Kelly Daniel for actively going out here and getting our scores from our matches that are taking place and keeping our ticker up to date. Certainly appreciate that. I'm sure our fans appreciate that. We can't possibly cover all the tables at this point in time. Maybe one day in the near future. But at the moment, we'll do our best to keep you up to date on all the scores, all the action. Right now, we've got Mark Gokey and Fred Crislip. Mark Gokey at the table. Fred with safety play there. Smart shot. Thank you. So, folks, you might see a little bit of adjustment with the video. We're trying to get the colors for the balls to come in a little bit better. We just want to make sure that we don't wash out the rest of the picture. But I think we're a little closer. So I can see the difference between the 7 and the 4 a little better. But we'll keep trying to adjust it. And thank you for the feedback in the chat. We do appreciate it. We do monitor the chat. So if there's anything you see or hear that needs to be fixed, let us know. We'll do our best. Thank you again for the feedback. I think we're pretty close now. Again, we do appreciate all of our fans and followers out there with the, for the feedback. And I was definitely having some issues with trying to determine what balls were which as well. So I think we're in better shape now. So Mark Gokey to the table on the 2. So we just heard Christina Madrigal called. It's one of the team THINKTECHMD players, female rep, sponsored player. Getting ready to go out there and do some business. All right, so Fred to the table, looking at that 2, going to probably kick off the short rail. I think if ideally you just want to make contact and maybe have the cue stay behind the 5 and a 4 find a rail. Excuse me, 2 find a rail, rather. And didn't want that. Ouch. So ball in hand given. Mark Gokey to the table. All right, so we're just getting a little information of the next match coming up. I'm going to have some of the females up on the table. Keep that under my hat for now. Who's playing? So Mark looking at this five ball. Thank Nick Spriggs, who's over here monitoring the chat. Once I get up and I'm shooting my match, he'll probably take over the commentary. So thank you to him. And we still got Scott out there and Kelly out there, keeping us up to speed with the current scores, keeping our ticker up to date. Thank you to them. And after this match, we're going to have the premiere of the Big Money gear. We're going to go ahead and put that up. Let you check out their gear over there in San Diego. Courtesy of Bernadine Diaz. Fred takes the lead, 5-1. Fred Crislip, the break, leading 5-1 over Mark Gokey. Missed the wing ball and the one ball on the side. Dry break. Mark Gokey to the table. Push is in play, as I mentioned. Good hit there by Mark. Wow, nice shot there by Fred. All right, so the jumper probably going to come out the bag here, I'd imagine. All right, it's got that Lambros jump cue. If you folks aren't familiar with the Lambros jumper, it's probably one of the best jumpers I've ever used. As a matter of fact, it is the best jumper I've ever used. I was part of the research and development team for Mike Lambros. And I had a lot of hours spent. Oh, Fred didn't quite get it up there. I had a lot of hours spent jumping that cue. So I was just having a chuckle. I was just talking about how great the jump cue was, and you know how that happens. But anyway, I was just saying to you, I was part of the research development team, and I will tell you that Lambros jumper is probably one of the best jumpers on the market. A lot of times there's jumpers out there that you can really jump, leave the table, but you can't get the cue ball to settle down. And other balls that you can get the cue ball to leave the table pretty quickly without energy, but then it doesn't carry. So I spent a lot of time working with Mike Lambros, sort of dialing that in with the right balance and weight. And I'll tell you, that's about one of the best jumpers out there. Certainly the best jumpers I've ever used. And Nick Spriggs, who said he loved it, or loves it. And so you can check it out. I'll be putting some videos up later about the jumper, some reviews from Edison Wu. Check that out. We'll be putting that up in a bit between matches. While we're on the topic of the Lambros cues, Mike Lambros just released his ultra low deflection shaft. He will only make that shaft for a Lambros cue. If you happen to order the Lambros Truth Series, and with the low deflection shaft, that is the, my opinion, the best system, low deflection system on the market. Doesn't just depend on the shaft. It's about the joint and some other things I really can't talk about. But one of the best low deflection, ultra low deflection systems on the market. And we'll put a video up of that with some of the testing from Edison Wu in a little bit. If you're not familiar who Edison Wu is, you can check him out on the Billiard Corner. You can check him out on Facebook. You can check him out there on YouTube. Content creator out there. Respected. Also like to say thank you to Anthony Munoz from Live on the Fly. He's a content creator as well. Goes out and does a lot of candid videos with pros and amateurs. We'll be putting some of that up a little later today. Great guy from out there in California. And all those folks out in California, we're thinking about you. You know, all the fires out there in the Midwest. We have a lot of family out there as far as in the pool community. We've been checking on our friends and family out there. Anthony, I hope everything's going well for you, sir. All right. So Fred kicking it. That's four ball. He's probably going to go two rails. He probably comes off the... Nope, hit it dead in the face. Good shot. For me, I would have tried to hit that the bottom rail, come off the side rail to the bottom rail, hitting the four, because that would have killed the cue ball and sent the four ball down table. But good hit by Fred. So Mark overcut that one a little bit.
He's not. So,
Safety play by Fred. Nice shot. Looks like Mark's going to go to the jumper. Also like to say thank you to Fast Signs out there in White Marsh, Maryland. Getting some signage done to go behind us in our booth. Sort of give us a little bit of a barrier. But that's in the works. Like to say thank you to those folks for all their hard work. It's not always about just getting in touch with a Fast Signs location. It's about having the right people at that location understand what you're looking for, can work with you. So I recommend the Fast Signs out of White Marsh.
I played in this year. I've been to Florida probably like 6 or 7 times. It's my first time playing. It's a good tournament. And you know what? There's no money involved in this, so, but you know what? It's actually a good tournament. I actually like it.
So Fred looking pretty good here to go up 6-1. This is certainly not a gimme. Well done by Fred, 6-1. Oh, that was that match? I must have missed a game somewhere. My apologies, folks. So 7-1, Fred over Mark.